another massive one with men, including me, is hair, like hair thickness and hairline. Like that's probably the biggest issue I've dealt with from the age of maybe like 18, 19.
And I couldn't believe this because he, when we started going out, you were using Rogaine and I had no idea. He used to hide it in his little bag of like his toothbrush and stuff.
Look at this stuff. You got old razors, Rogaine. Wait a minute. You use Rogaine? I didn't know you needed
it. It's preventative.
But is your hair falling?
I don't want to talk about it!
And I didn't know, and you never said it to me. You didn't say it to me for months and months and months. And I was so glad when you finally did, because like I had no idea how much it bothered you until then. And it really shocked me, actually, like that it was a thing that you were... Because I always perceived you as so confident, because you are a very confident person, I think, maybe from the bullying. Like, it really thickened your skin.
Yeah.
And you don't care about, like, necessarily other people's perception of it, but how you see yourself. It's like when you're looking at yourself in the mirror, like, not seeing yourself.
Yeah, definitely. As I've gotten older, I've stopped really caring what other people think. But it's definitely an issue that I've had. Like, when I was, like, 18, 19, maybe my concerns were a little bit premature, you know? Like, I had quite a big floppy fringe. But as I got older, there was a bit less hair there. Then I started noticing I had to gel my fringe up, which was good. Then I had my big quiff, and my quiff became my trademark. But I had this quiff. But I noticed that, like, when I didn't want the quiff and I gelled my hair down, there was just that little bit less hair in my fringe. And as I got older, probably around 2016, I realized, like, I can't gel my hair down anymore because it looks ridiculous. It's just a strand and it was so thin. And now it's like really going back. Like I gel my hair forward quite a lot. I kind of keep it long and gel it forward to try and cover it up a bit. But
why, where do you think that insecurity comes from? Because so many, it's just normal that men lose hair as they get older. So it's like, it's kind of like the thing with wrinkles. Like, people want to avoid wrinkles even though everyone gets wrinkles.
Yeah, for me, it's about looking in the mirror and not really recognizing the person there anymore. Because with hairline and hair thickness, like, it changes the shape of your face. It really does. And then also, like, I tried to just run with it and I was like, okay, I'm going to be one of those cool shaved head guys. Did a zero all
you
over.
You looked so hot with the shaved head. I loved it.
And like everyone said it suited me. And I looked in the mirror and I was like, yeah, it kind of does suit me as well. But at the same time, I still didn't feel like I looked like myself. You know, I missed just having the quiff. I missed just having a bit of extra thickness. Like, for me, it's not really about the hairline. It's more the fact that you can see through
it. Do men say comments to each other? Like, do people say things to you?
Well, I was going into work one day and it was a particularly wet day and one of the lads in the office called me Dr. Phil. I think it was really funny. I didn't appreciate it. Once I kind of accepted these issues and was open enough to talking to my friends about them, quite a few of them were instantly like, I know, like, I'm like that as well. Like, look at this and look at that.
Yeah.
Like, and I realized these guys who I saw every day, who I thought were like really confident, who had no issues with this type of stuff, were the exact same as me and were so excited to talk about it just because I brought it up.
I remember a friend of mine, Riyad, made a YouTube video about his dad getting a hair transplant.
Yeah. We're going to do a little chat now for a video that I'm doing with Melanie tomorrow. Isn't that right?
Right.
It's not to do with Melanie at all, actually.
No, oh dear.
Not at all.
Yeah, this is shit.
No. It's actually about you.
What?
Remember we went for the consultation for your hair?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We're going to get it done as a gift for you.
What? Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Hey!
Isn't that great?
Really?
Yeah.
No way.
Absolutely,
but it was the first time I really, like, thought about the fact that, like, yeah, guys go and do this all the time, and not even celebrities, like footballers and news presenters, and it's become really common, but it's not talked about much. It's actually quite similar, I feel like, in my world, in my internet bubble, of like a lot of people get fillers, and I've never had anything, any cosmetic procedures done to my face other than the acne scar treatment, but so many other people, like, they'll get fillers and in their faces and in their lips and stuff, but they'll not talk about it. And then I feel like that kind of sets this unrealistic, like,
expectation.
With the hair transplant stuff, like, you told me when he finally told me that he had an insecurity about his hair, he told me that you'd been looking into getting a hair transplant, and you were like, I'm definitely getting one. It's just no question about it.
It was a question of when rather than if. I'd been looking into it, like, from probably my early 20s. I was kind of convinced, yeah, when I am in a position to be able to get this, I'm going to do it, because this isn't going away. I just want to look like me, like the me that I see in my head. I want to see him again. Getting the hair transplant, it's just getting the top of my head just looking the way it did like 5 years ago, which would be great, because then I'd feel a bit more like myself when I look in the mirror, and not like, I don't know, I just feel like I look different. I don't think I look bad. I think I just look different.
Like, it doesn't affect how I view you, and, you know, no one thinks any less of you for your hair being thinner and stuff. But you, the way you explained it to me is, like, it's not about that. It's about yourself and your inner kind of, so I suppose, self-image or self-esteem about yourself. So you want to do it so that you're dealing with less insecurity on a day-to-day basis.
Well, yeah, like, because you have to listen to me, because I make comments on it probably every day.
He
does,
yeah, he comments on it. He's always like, I only have two hairs.
And I don't realise that I do it as well.
He calls himself Homer Simpson all the time.
I try and make jokes out of it just to kind of deal with it, but, like, it does really bother me.
So anyway, because he was just constantly bringing it up, he always said he would get it done in his 40s, which is when most men do tend to go and get a hair transplant. So our wedding, obviously, wasn't able to go ahead with COVID and stuff like that. We did get married, but we didn't have, like, the whole big, big wedding and stuff. And then I just remember during the whole lockdown and all, I was trying to, like, have things for both of us to look forward to and stuff. And because your 30th is next year, I surprised him and I said, like, look, I'll do this for you if you would like to do it. And you were very, very, very happy.
I was so shocked as well. I know a lot of people kind of go abroad to save a bit of cash, but I have seen quite a lot of horror stories online.
Same.
And over the course of the years of me looking into it, the same name always kept coming up. It was Hair Restoration Blackrock, which was where Riyadh went when we were talking about Riyadh's dad. They went down there. So yeah, I feel like I've, like, 10 years of research done on this place now. Like, they're fully accredited. Loads of celebs have been there and they've trusted them. It's a company that specialise in hair loss treatment, so they really do know what they're talking about. And people fly in from all over the world to go to this place. And it's only down the road. Yeah. So,
and they're very private. Like, when we went in there first, you did a consultation with... And they do consultation with an actual doctor as well.
Yeah.
And they'll dissuade you from getting a hair transplant if you don't need one. So they really look out for, like, the people who go there. But they're really private in that. So many men are so, like, private about getting this stuff done.
Yeah.
Which makes me really sad, and that's kind of why a big reason we wanted to talk about this in a video, because they have it set up so that the men don't have to bump into anyone on their way in and out, and
you will not,
which is amazing, but I wish they didn't have to do that.
Yeah, you will not see another patient when you're in there. Like, you're brought through the hall when it's clear, and they're brought through the hall when you're safely in your room.
Yeah.
And I can completely understand why guys would be delighted with that, to be honest with you. So I first off went in for a consultation and got some photos taken of my hair and that type of a thing, and they kind of asked me questions about what I was having the biggest issue with, which was, as I said, the thickness of the hair.
See, girls can just go and put in hair extensions. Yeah. You know, and what they do, by the way, is they take hairs from back here and then they'll put them in here. So it's not like they're getting some random person's hair and putting it into your head, or like fake hair. It's like it's your own hair that they're moving. But you did that, like, with the pictures and all that, and then you went in for a design process.
So during the design process, they look at what size of transplant you're looking for. So based on your financial situation and also your needs, they'll decide what kind of package suits you.
There's two different types, isn't there?
So there's FUE and there's FUT. But yeah, so they draw a line in your head, which just looks a bit mental. But I was really shocked as well about how much hairline they were going to be able to give me back, because that wasn't even one of the things I was looking for.
But they stagger it though, right? It's not like that line. Like, they don't just put it on like that. They make it look very natural.
It's not like a doll's hair. They're basically what they say is, if I was to lose all the rest of my hair, it'd still look natural, which is good, you know? So in 20, 30 years' time, when lots of my other hairs have fallen out, I won't be left with like a patch and then like nothing behind it. Like, it'll look natural. So I'm getting it done in December. It's all booked in. This is crazy. I can't wait.
You're so excited about it. It's going to be me after a few kids when I'm getting my first boob lift. I do think that's a big element of confidence as well, is being open and transparent about your insecurities and stuff. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's very difficult to get to the point where you can talk about this stuff. So I think it says a lot about a person, especially a man, to have the courage to talk about this stuff. Because I think that it takes a lot of bravery to be like, oh yeah, no, I'm insecure about this, I'm going to do something about it. Like, so many people would be so insecure about it that they wouldn't even, like, you know,
acknowledge
it. Yeah, like, I know there's just so many guys I've known with, like, issues that they just... it's like it cripples them, like, you know what I mean? And I'm so glad that you talk about this with me, and not just with me, but like online, because even if like 5 or 10 people watching this or see this through their girlfriends or their whatever, like, and feel, I don't know, a bit more heard or seen.
I definitely think it's a lot, it's an issue that a lot of men deal with. A lot of other lads, like, they lose their hair and they're just like, cool, this is what I look like now, great. But I just don't have that. I have an image of myself in my head and I miss it, you know? So I have the opportunity to get it back, so I'm going to take it.